Now that we have our finished application, we're ready to deploy it to SAP BTP Cloud Foundry. We'll use the Task Explorer and one of the built-in tasks to both enable discovery of our service and to deploy the project to SAP BTP. The project will be built and then an archive created, an MTAR, a multi-target application archive. And this will all be sent to BTP so that we can run it there. And all this is done from the single task definition. Now, at this point, the deployment actually pauses for a moment. It needs to log into Cloud Foundry to deploy our application. So I'm going to go back to the BTP cockpit, and I need to look up the API endpoint of my subaccount so that I can put that in so it knows where to connect to. Now, actually, the default value for me was correct, but I always like to check it just in case. And then I'll use the SSO option. I'll actually authenticate in a web browser. That way I don't have to put in my username and password. It's going to give me a temporary code that I can put in for authentication. That only lasts a few seconds, so it's even safe to show here in the video. Now it's connecting me and it needs to know my Cloud Foundry organization, which I can have multiple of in a subaccount, and my space. Now that I've authenticated and I told it the target of where I want to deploy, it can continue with the deployment.